The three sisters killed in Timaru in 2021 died because their mother wanted them dead. That's the majority verdict from the jury, who found 42-year-old Lauren Dickason guilty of murder. It rejected defences of insanity and infanticide, finding she killed her children in a clinical, calculated way. Now, just before we go any further, a warning, some details ahead may be distressing. Shortly, we'll look at the circumstances that led to the tragedy, but first, Lisa Davies has been in court throughout the trial. She joins us now live from Christchurch. Lisa, talk us through what happened in court today.
Well, Simon, as you can probably imagine, the courtroom was tense. It was highly emotionally charged. And after 15 hours, the jurors declared they could not reach a unanimous verdict. They were told to go back and see if they could reach a majority verdict, which they did, 11 to 1, guilty of murder. They're not the words that Lauren Dickason's parents wanted to hear. They became very emotional and were hugged by supporters in the public gallery. We heard jurors crying as they left the room. Their job has been such a difficult one. Lauren Dickason appeared to remain emotionless, however, as she learned her fate. Triple child killer Lauren Dickason looked stunned but remained calm after being convicted of murdering her young daughters in cold blood.
Do 11 of you find the defendant, Lauren Ann Dickason, guilty of murder, or do you find the defendant, Lauren Ann Dickason, not guilty of murder?
Guilty of murder. Guilty of murder. Guilty of murder.
Three identical verdicts for three little girls, her defence team looking at the jury in disbelief. Her parents, who've been in court every day of the trial, became emotional in the public gallery, issuing this statement of love and support.
This was not our daughter, but a debilitating mental illness which resulted in an awful tragedy. Our beloved Leone, Carla and Maya were taken from this life to another as a result of this crippling disease.
This is the very kind of case that the law of infanticide was designed for.
But the jury didn't accept she was still suffering from postpartum depression when she ended the lives of 6-year-old Leone and 2-year-olds Maya and Carla in a lengthy, violent attack. Also finding she wasn't insane and knew what she was doing was morally wrong.
The first twin was being really, really, really horrible to me lately. That's why I did her first.
The Crown said that comment in her police interview was proof it was murder. On three occasions, she'd shared thoughts with her husband about harming their girls.
She specifically said that she feels like she can sedate the children and so that it can just all be over.
After hearing her many angry texts about the children and 8 deleted internet searches on how to kill children,
fatal levels of lethal dosage,
the jury agreed she resented her girls and wanted them dead. The violent, prolonged attack ended with her smothering them.
Were they saying anything to you, Lauren?
Not the two little ones, but the oldest one was very angry and she wants to know why I'm doing this to them because I'm the best mum and she loves me.
She recalled an, quote, out-of-body experience, like I was up above, end quote. At no point in time did she reconsider what she was doing, explaining, quote, they would have known what I did.
With Crown experts maintaining this mother didn't kill out of love, quite the opposite.
Any altruistic motivation was, in my opinion, fueled more so by a need for control and anger.
The judge thanking the jurors for their service on this harrowing trial.
You've had to deal with distressing evidence. And I acknowledge that this trial has likely taken a toll on you personally. You can take considerable pride in the way you've carried out your duties.
This triple murderer will now be medically assessed to help determine the type and length of sentence to be imposed. But nothing can undo the life sentence she handed down to her own little girls.
And today's verdict ends 4 weeks of harrowing evidence. The horrific and heartbreaking saga starting with a family's move to start a new life in New Zealand. On September the 11th, 2021, the Dickason family of Lauren, Graham and their three children left managed isolation after emigrating from South Africa. The three young girls were killed 4 days later while their father was at a Timaru hospital work function. The next day, Lauren Dickason is charged with murdering her daughters. She appears in court the following day and is remanded to a psychiatric unit at Hillmorton Hospital in Christchurch. On the 5th of August 2022, a trial date is set for the following year. 10 months later, it's revealed Dickason's entered pleas of not guilty by reason of insanity and infanticide. The trial begins in the High Court in Christchurch on July 17, and today, a verdict. Lauren Dickason, guilty of murder. Lisa is with us again now. Lisa, take this forward for us. What happens next?
Well, usually when someone is convicted of murder, they'll be sent straight to prison. Lauren Dickason is tonight back in a forensic unit at Hillmorton Mental Health Hospital. She will be assessed there to enable the judge to appropriately sentence her for her crime.
And Lisa, you were in court the whole trial. What's left the deepest impression on you?
Well, Simon, this is one of the saddest rooms I've ever been in. It was often a case of the air being thick with grief. And as the little girl's grandparents so aptly put it, there are no winners in this tragedy. It's their firm belief that it was mental illness, not their daughter, that robbed them of their granddaughters, those precious little girls, Leonie, Maya and Carla. May they rest in peace.
Tēnā koe, Lisa. Thank you very much.